One year after my first AIDS test, when I had tested negative, I decided to have another test. This time, the results were not as good. John Holmes. 12. Rehearsal for retirement. End of an era. Arrival of AIDS. Richard Pacheco. Herpes was a disease which, in the wrong context, could have serious consequences. For me, in 1979, with my wife trying to get pregnant with our first child, we learned a birth with a herpes-infected woman could be brain-damaging to the baby. At that point, I started saying to producers and directors alike, I won't work with anybody who has herpes. That was not greeted well by most producers and directors who didn't want to hear anything about what you wanted. Contracts with health-oriented demands would soon become more common as new sexual health risks emerged. Although it is likely that AIDS was introduced to the United States in the 1970s, everyone was ignorant of its existence for over a decade. Beginning in 1981, doctors noted an unexplained outbreak of opportunistic infections among gay men on both coasts of the United States. Americans became concerned about the risks of contagion, so the Centers for Disease Control began investigating the staggering amount of new cases of Kaposi's sarcoma and other opportunistic infections. In July of that year, a doctor from the CDC assured the public that there was no apparent risk to the non-homosexual population, because at that time, no one outside the gay male community showed signs of the mysterious virus. So experts wondered if the use of drugs called poppers had put the gay population at risk. But by December of 1981, it became clear that intravenous drug users were also at risk, after several were diagnosed with the rare pneumonia that had been documented among the gay men. By the middle of 1982, 452 cases had been reported among 23 states. But there was still no name for the virus that many people were referring to as gay cancer. In July, the CDC introduced the acronym AIDS, which stands for Acquired Immune Deficiency Syndrome, and identified four risk factors: homosexuality, intravenous drug abuse, Haitian origin, and hemophilia A. But even the CDC still did not precisely understand the methods of transmission or the cause of AIDS. Some Americans were apathetic about AIDS because they believed that it only affected gay men and drug users. But late that year, a 20-month-old baby died from AIDS-related infections after receiving a blood transfusion. By 1983, doctors were puzzled, and panic set in among the public after non-drug-using women and children in America were diagnosed with AIDS and contributed to the 3,000 known cases and 1,000 AIDS-related deaths. As a result, the CDC added a fifth risk group: female sexual partners of men with AIDS. Richard Pacheco. In 1984, on November 4th, I believe, there was a headline in the San Francisco Chronicle, "Two men get AIDS by having sex with women." It was the first announcement of the heterosexual transmission of AIDS, and it was the end of the sexual revolution, because now we were back to that notion that some serious bad could happen here. For the first of the AIDS epidemic, there was no talk of safe sex. Nobody knew what was causing it. In Florida, they thought mosquitoes spread the disease, which was logical. There was panic. Doctors recognized that HIV caused AIDS in 1984 and developed methods to test blood for HIV antibodies in 1985. By that time, the virus had been documented in all parts of the world. The actor, Rock Hudson, died from AIDS-related infections on October 3, 1985. Everyone worried about their risk of contracting HIV.